First up, we've got Charlie Brooker and David Mitchell. As is tradition on this show, I hope you've come up with funny pub quiz team names. Anything?
Yeah. Define funny.
Just a pub
if
quiz.
If they promise to laugh after whatever we say, it'll seem OK, right?
Yeah! The deal has been struck.
Oh, this is marvellous. We were thinking maybe ignorance and want. Thank you. That was an extremely fake laugh.
Ignorance and want.
Yeah, because
and who would be who?
We wouldn't specify. You could decide.
Ooh, press the red button now.
Well done.
Jonathan, what? Those aren't your glasses.
What you're looking at here, Carr, is a masterclass in quiz psychology. Because when they look over here now, they see a movie star and a scientist.
Sorry, you're wearing those glasses to attempt to look like a nerd to impress David Mitchell.
I can tell that there is no glass in those glasses. Which immediately makes me think that you're a spy working for a poor country. We haven't got a clue. No, I think Charlie has a very vague idea that it might be something he hasn't heard. I'm convinced it's something I haven't heard. But it's difficult for me to select from all the billions of things I haven't heard which one it is.
Yeah, if it's not on Phil Collins's No Jacket Required, you really haven't got much of a chance.
Well, actually, you're way behind, because just the other day, I was writing in a newspaper how I've also bought Susan Boyle's album. What? I've now bought two albums, and have consequently concluded that music is shit.
Well, good luck with that question.
That means your entire record collection are the tracks that we put on when we want people to leave at the end of the party. That's all you've got.
I think, basically, deep down, I want myself to leave.
This is meant to be a festive quiz, not an intervention.
Pity! Yeah, marvellous. The interviewer is interesting there, because he said to him, that is the most persistent fly I've ever seen, which I don't believe him. If he's seen equally persistent flies, maybe one or two more persistent flies. He's trying to suck up to Obama, saying, you're being troubled by that fly, but that's no reflection on you, because that is the most persistent fly.
Now that you've heard it properly.
No.
Why not?
It's all right. I'm not sorry it stopped.
Do you ever... urge to bust a move to that banging tune? I was looking over and you didn't move neither. You sat there stolid and unhappy. Stewing in your own middle-aged juices.
He's genuinely scared about that.
Oh, seriously, I think you're going to love it.
Dance on
you're
going to
love it. And I'm telling you, you dance, I guarantee you'll lose your virginity this year. Because if no one else offers, I'll do it. I'll take it for you.
You're going to fuck me up the arse, is that what you're saying? That's torture. The cat's going, what the fuck is going on? It's clearly they've stuck rods up its paws from behind. They're using a live cat as a puppet. That's disgusting.
So is that not going to be your third record purchase?
I don't like that. And, you know, in general, I'm kind of OK with a bit of cruelty to animals, but that goes too far. But actually, we initially went with Santa Claus, different pun, but still...
Slightly better.
Still, yeah, slightly better. We crossed out Santa Claus and put the funny internet cat, which I think you'll agree is broadly right.
It could have been anywhere, couldn't they?
Well, have a guess.
Right.
Name a place.
Yeah, that's great. Oh.
OK, you've all got something for this? You went for Charlie and David?
Redditch.
I thought you might have been to Redditch. And that became an internet phenomenon.
You said guess. We guessed wrongly. The first one is cat torture. Now we're sort of a distressed child on some sort of horrendous narcotic. I mean, isn't the internet fun?
I asked you what was going on with this hat. What did you all get?
Derek Acora held a sort of hour-long televised lie. he put on a voice in front of some very damaged people.
It was, of course, Derek Acora's live seance where he absolutely 100% for real contacted and channeled the spirit of Michael Jackson. Let's have a look at what Michael Jackson had to say from beyond.
One of them looked frighteningly like you.
What?
There you are.
He got in touch with him. He didn't ask him anything about any of the allegations or how he died or anything like that. He talked about a bit about his hat. for 20 minutes and said that he loved all his fans.
You imagine that if he had got in touch with a recently dead Michael Jackson, he would probably want to talk about the circumstances of his death as a priority. That would be much on his mind.
I think he warned him first. He said, none of that, Mike.
We're not going to ask you about that.
No.
But he presumably said, actually, I really want to talk about that because I just died under slightly odd circumstances and I want to clear it up. I'm pissed off. I died when I was 50. Despite all my wealth, I died under the average age of death. I didn't have a terminal disease. I'm angry about that. Now, we want to talk about your hat. I'm ringing off.
One of them, he was looking at the hat of a man he admired. He couldn't believe it. I can't believe that that's his hat. Well, frankly, if you can't believe that's his hat, how the hell are you going to believe that this Liverpudlian is talking this?
David.
Oh, I'm surprised you brought that up.
I didn't say anything. I merely couldn't resist the urge to move in time with the swaying beat.
We got one. Well, Charlie knew one.
Well, I don't know if I know it. Do they use words to refer to the rounds on that programme?
They do, yeah. Sort of... Dizzy Dummies is absolutely right.
Right. Wow, then... well done. Yeah.
The
yeah.
bit where they fall in the water.
That's all of it. No, the rest of it is just the bit where they fall in the water again and again and again.
Don't you like it?
No.
I think it's Rachel.
It's one of the... It's a real sort of Marmite flipping thing, isn't it? Where you either get it or you don't. I just see people tumbling into the water 200 times in a row and it makes me quite angry.
I've even watched the same episode 3 or 4 times. That's how much I like it. And I managed to forget who's won and still get excited.
What is wrong with you?
I love
so
it.
Many things.
Sometimes I watch episodes of Antiques Roadshow for the second time. That's a very lonely moment. Yeah. Initially, you don't know you've seen it before, and then you start to think you can guess how much things are worth. And then you think you're an antiques expert. You realise, no, it's not that. I know what you mean, the punch face. Yes, that is definitely the best bit.
The big piston punch
watching
face.
Watching someone walking along wondering if they're going to get punched in the face.
Punched in the face.
Get punched in the face. Yes.
And then they get back up and do it again. It's unbelievably good.
The game's called, it's called Sucker Punch, that one.
Oh, so no, no, it's Punch Face.
It's weird, it is the only place you can watch a woman being punched in the face and it's Saturday Night Entertainment.
He commissioned murder. So he presents a show a bit like Crime Watch. He commissioned people to be killed and then was first on the scene and the police found out because every time they went to a murder scene, there he was filming going, aha, let us look at the evidence.
John Nettles did that. They got a whole other series out of it. He did it once on Bergerac, and it worked. Midsummer Murders, that's what he's doing now. He kills people. The writers come in, sort of zhuzh it up a bit.
Stuart Broad asked you what was sung to him during the Ashes this year. What did you all get?
Yeah, yeah, dude looks like a lady. I feel pretty. I feel pretty. I feel. Is it that?
We didn't specify, we just said an erotic ballad. rather hauntingly beautiful and yet specifically genital song. It was sung by all the members of the MCC from the pavilion.
That's it, yeah, and it eats rats.
A rat insect.
A plant that can eat a rat.
Mm. Yes.
Wow.
Presumably the rat has to stay still for quite a long time.
It's going to be quite a docile rat.
Yeah.
Not
well,
the
basically, got to be a rat with a death wish. Yeah, rats get really depressed. They know there's a certain sort of plant they sort of climb into. Who gives a shit? France, Ireland, it's all abroad.
Do you have anything to say?
No.
Do you have a dance you want to do?
No, I'd rather not do a dance.
This we can do this the easy way or the hard way. Yeah.
This is society at its ugliest.
Yeah, no, this all get no. Okay. So no. But thanks for coming. And bye.